Hi, Terry. How have you been doing? Firstly, I wanted to ask you, FA Cup final this weekend, Arsenal taking on Chelsea. Arsenal finished 8th this season. How important is this game for the Gunners and Arteta to still finish the season on somewhat of a high?
I think it's very important for both managers, aren't they? Obviously, Frank being at the helm for 50-odd games now at Chelsea, we know that. And Arteta coming in at a sticky period in Arsenal's time, you know, finishing 8th in the EPL wasn't really good enough. The last time they finished outside the top 6 was 12th, was in 1995. So, you know, they'll have to put that one right. I think he's got in there, he's got a lot of younger players in there, as we know, and he's trying to blend that youth with a lot of the older boys. I think it's very important for Arsenal, isn't it? It's not just that's the European place at cost and all. Plus, it's a trophy. I mean, it'd be wonderful for him to go out there and win the trophy, plus get Arsenal into Europe and all. It'd be a wonderful time for him and the Arsenal club, plus the fans and all, to get some silverware, plus be in Europe and all. So, two rolls of the dice there.
And Aubameyang, I mean, 22 goals he scored in the Premier League this season. Surely he has to be the biggest threat for Arsenal, for Chelsea in this FA Cup final.
Oh, I would presume so. You know, if they can get him good service in and around the 18-yard box, get him in between the lines and attacking Chelsea's back four, he's got a great chance. We know what he's all about. He's quick, he's lively, he's got a great eye for goal. He's sharp, he brings other players into the game and all. He drifts off defenders, waits for defenders to go to sleep. And that's where he's at his best. You know, for him to be scoring over all competitions, I think he's got 27 goals over all competitions. That's absolutely fantastic.
Speaking of Chelsea, you've played for Chelsea before. Chelsea had all sorts of problems at the start of the season. A new inexperienced coach in Lampard. There was a transfer window ban. There was no big striker. It didn't look like they have a big striker. First game of the season, 4-0 down to United. Yet, they have finished 4th. What has Lampard done right for the club this season?
I think, you know, Lampard went into a sticky situation at the start, didn't he? You know, there was a ban. There was a transfer ban on him. And he's got a fantastic coach with him called Jody Morris. And he was working at Chelsea. He's played for Chelsea. And, you know, he's the owner in the background. You know, he did a lot of the youth sector. He had the youth teams at that time when he was there. And I think Frank went in there. He's gone, listen, I can't go out. I can't buy no one. Let's give the youth a chance. And it was great for the youth players to come in there. You know, Mason Mount, you know, Abraham, Hudson-Odoi, all these wonderful players who've been given the chance. And to tell you the truth, they're the ones who have got Chelsea where they are. Plus, then you've got the older people like Giroud in there, Kante in there. I know he's been injured a little bit. So you've got the old foe in there and all. Barkley, he's really come to form. So Chelsea have got a little youth on blend. I know Arsenal are trying to do that at the moment. But I think Frank has had his time. He's had a settled team. They're just conceding too many goals at the back, which we know that probably around about 54 goals, 50-odd goals this season, which is not really good enough, you know. So for me, they need to, you know, sort that one out. But on the other hand, they've got some fantastic youngsters. I think Giroud's done well, very well. You know, they have scored a ratio of goals as Chelsea. Everybody's chipped in for goals from midfield, up at the front and even at the back. So they can score goals from all different areas of the park.
And speaking of the Premier League champions, Liverpool, after they were declared the champions, they had a bit of a up and down. They lost to Arsenal, they lost to City, they drew against Burnley. I mean, do you think there was some sort of lack of motivation towards the end for Liverpool?
I think there's always a little lack of motivation, isn't there? Because let's not forget, I think we tied the EPL up by late January, early February. It was already done and dusted. It's just being professional and, you know, going out and doing your job and not letting you down because you still want momentum. You still want to win games. You know, they was going for the point system. They wanted over 100 points. They just missed out on that, obviously, which Man City have still got that record with the 100 points. So for me, you know, it's two ways, isn't it? You know, don't forget, in the back of your head, you've won it. Do you really want to go out there and get injured as a player? Not really. You know, so you just probably go through the motions that little bit less than you would do if it was probably 5 or 6 points in it. But you still got to look at each game in the same way. But I think with Liverpool, they've been fantastic over the last few years. You know, Champions League finals, obviously winning other trophies and winning the EPL after 30 years is absolutely brilliant for them. Brilliant for the city and brilliant for Liverpool. And Klopp himself, don't forget, his dad been to finals with, you know, the Europa final he went to, he lost. You know, FA Cup finals he's been to, he's lost. So I think that was the motivation for the whole of the club, the supporters, was to win this EPL, and that's what they've done. And they only missed out last year, to tell you the truth, by 1 point. Manchester City pipped them.
And speaking of Manchester United, Ole, at the start of the season, had a whirlwind of criticism by the end of 2019. And somehow it all turned around in 2020. What do you think got right in 2020 for Solskjaer?
I just think Fernandes coming in, he did a wonderful job. You know, him coming in, he settled things a little bit. You know, he was scoring goals. I know a lot of them was from the penalty spot, but goals are goals at the end of the day, and they do win you games. And, you know, if you win games, you look where they are. I don't think anybody gave Manchester United a hell's an hope of a chance of even reaching the top four. You know, they're still in the Europa League. Now they've got a great chance of winning this Europa League. I think they've got the best chance out of anybody. I can see them in Inter Milan, maybe in the final. That'd be a fantastic game if Manchester United do get through the next couple of games. I just think basically, he, Rashford come to form, Fernandes come to form. You know, it's the key players what come to form at the right time. He's still got problems at the back. It's not all done and dusted yet. He will have to go out and buy. We do know that. We'll see Manchester United in the next two transfer windows to see what they really can do, especially this transfer window coming up, to see if they're going to, if he buys the right players, what type of players is he going to buy? I think Pogba needs to still pull his socks up a little bit. Obviously, fitness-wise, he was injured, and then we had the break because of the COVID-19, and he's come back. I think he's got a lot more to offer, to tell you the truth in there, but I just don't think the greatest at the back. I think they do need another centre-back, maybe another attacking midfield player, and maybe a forward in one or two of the wide areas in case they do get injuries, Manchester United.
And speaking of former Manchester United manager Jose Mourinho, it has been a struggle for him to pick up Tottenham from where Pochettino had left the club. You think Mourinho is the right fit for the mentality of players like Kane, Son, Ali, who are constantly attacking, moving forward? Do you think he's the right fit for the club?
I think he plays a different style, doesn't he? We all know what Mourinho's about. He's a serial winner. We know he wins trophies. He's just got him in. You know, you seen him celebrating the other day. You know, getting into the Europa League. You know, Tottenham have been in the top four for the last few years and been getting into the Champions League. So for him to be jumping about and celebrating to get to Europa League just tells you how much it meant to Mourinho. He was under pressure a lot. I mean, it takes time, doesn't it? He knows what he's doing. You know, you've got to give a manager time. I don't think he got the time at Manchester United, even though he won trophies there. I don't think he got the time. It was the Manchester United philosophy. The supporters didn't like it. You know, the way he played. He's very strict, very regimental. And I think he's trying a little bit of that at Tottenham Hotspur. But I think he's got to let the quality players, let them be free. Take the reins off them. You know, Harry Kane will score goals wherever he'll go. He showed you that. 20 goals plus a season, striker, absolutely fantastic. Song, we know what he's all about, Son. You know, drifting off the wide area, he's got an eye for goal. I think Mourinho will bring one or two players in, his own style, his own fit, maybe to strengthen things up a little bit. But I think in that maybe latter, middle to third, he's got to be a bit more exciting, a bit more expansive in his play if he wants to get Tottenham to the next level, because that's the type of players he's got in there. They want to be expansive, enjoyable, exciting, and he'll need to trust the players and allow the players to do that.
And then speaking of promotions, Leeds United will be returning to Premier League. 16 years, with Marcelo Bielsa. I mean, it seems like about the biggest promotion in a long, long time. How do you see Bielsa's Leeds getting next year?
I think, well, Leeds are my old team. That's where I first, I get a goose pimple now. That's where I first started as a 12-year-old. I ended up playing in the first team there. You know, when you walk into Leeds, it's, you know, it's a fantastic place to walk into. You know, the history of the club from the 50s, 60s through the 70s with some wonderful, wonderful players. You know, ex-managers of mine, Jack Charlton, Billy Brenner, Terry Yorriff, Eddie Gray, Alan Clark, they was all ex-managers of mine when I was at Leeds and when I was at the Ireland team. So I know Leeds very well. I know the passion of the fans very well. I know what it means to the fans after 16 years to get back into the EPL. It's absolutely fantastic. The manager is a serious workhorse. He works his butt off. He knows what he's doing. He studies the game and he studies it even more. So don't tell me he will be studying it right now. He'll go through every team, the weaknesses, the strengths of the team, through every individual player of every team, the weaknesses and strengths, how they play, where the best moments are, where the weak moments are, on every blade of grass. Trust me, the problem is, does he go out and buy players? Is there going to be funds there to buy players? Or is he going to come in, stay with the players he's got and hope? Because it is a big test. We see Sheffield United do it. We see Aston Villa, who spent 140 million dancing about because they just missed out relegation. Now relegation, 140 million, they just started dancing about and missed out on that. So it is very difficult. And it's very difficult for new teams to come in because, you know, you're playing against teams who have got the money to spend, the top teams. And then you're playing against teams who know how to win in the EPL and all. So it'll be a big one for them. And I hope Leeds will stay in there for the four coming years and forever, because that's where they need to be, Leeds United. It'll be fantastic.
And just like one last question about your another biggest club of yours, Manchester City, who faced FFP and UEFA Champions League controversy, the ban that happened. You think Guardiola will have an extra motivation or kind of a pressure on himself to win it this year? Already there's this thing that hasn't won the Champions League with City, and with all the negative press that happened with his Champions League campaign. Do you think he has an extra motivation or pressure about
that? I think you've hit the nail right on the head there with the added pressure. I think there's always pressure on Pep, isn't there? No matter where he goes to win the Holy Grail, the Champions League. I think it's every manager, but I think there seems to be more pressure on Pep wherever he goes. I don't think he brings it on himself. I mean, there was are they going to be banned from Europe? Are they not going to be banned from Europe? They got found not guilty, but yet they got fined 40 million. But yet they never got found guilty. How does that work out? I don't understand that one. Obviously, they're guilty or they're not guilty. So somewhere along the lines, they've had to take the rap and take a fine and just show, just put out there to other teams, if you mess about, you know, and you go over the limits, then, you know, you're going to get the chances of being evicted from the Europe or having a heavy fine. Now, I'm sure the Man City hierarchy are happy with the fine. You know, deep down, happy with the fine. It gives Pep another chance, doesn't it? I don't think it'll be motivation. The motivation will already be there. The motivation will already be there for the players. Don't forget, he's two games away from the final. He's 2 games away from the final. You know, he'll probably never be as close. I know a couple of years ago, under Pellegrini, they got to the semi-finals and they blew the chances there. He's got a great chance, and Manchester City have got a great chance. Now, the problem is, did he get too overexcited? Did the players freeze against Real Madrid? It's a fantastic opportunity, the 2-1 up. You know, it's all up to Real Madrid. The Real Madrid come out and leave gaps for Manchester City to exploit. And they're the best team in the world at exploiting space and gaps and knowing how to unlock that lock with the golden key. So I think for Pep, he'll take it just in his stride and the players will take it in his stride. I expect Manchester City to win this one. I expect him to go on to the final.
Thank you, Danny, for taking time out to speak to us.
Thank you very much. Brilliant. Thank you very much.